Hello, so now I'll be discussing current major circuits but for BJT circuits. Previously we discussed for MOS circuit. So we will consider two cases. In first case, beta is very high, and in second case, beta is finite. So in first case, we will consider beta as infinite. But before that, let us note difference between this MOS and BJTs, okay? Especially in case of mirror circuits. That is current mirror circuit. So first point is that obviously the analysis with BJT will be complicated. Why so? Because here we have non-zero base current. Clear? So non-zero base over there in MOS case the base current is zero. That is gate current. Gate current is zero. So directly whatever is drain current is equivalent to source current. But here non-zero base current will add some extra complexity. Also, current transfer ratio is determined by relative areas of emitter, relative areas of emitter base junctions of Q1 and Q2 transistor. Over there, the ratio was determined by aspect ratios, W by L ratio, okay, of both Q1 and Q2. That is, ratio of aspect ratios will determine the current transfer ratio. Over here, the area of emitter base junction. So higher the area of the emitter base junction, higher will be the current flowing to that particular transistor. So first case we consider beta is very high. So in this case, the base current is zero. We can say since beta is very high, base current is zero. And so simple case, so just like MOS over here, and we can say that neglecting our base current. So I reference is passed through diode corrected transistor Q1 and thus establish corresponding voltage this plus VBE. And this plus VBE is applied as base to emitter voltage of this transistor Q2. Now also assume that Q1 and Q2 are matched for simplicity now. So matched, it implies that emitter base junction area of Q2 is same as that of area of Q1. And thus we can say that this I naught current which is flowing is same as I reference. So this is a point for case number one. Okay, and one important point which we can't neglect is that in order to have this operation, our Q2 must be operating in active mode. Okay. Over there also we discussed the same thing, that is in MOS case we told that it must be in saturation region, whereas in this we can say it is in active mode. Okay, so and this can be achieved only when V naught, that is this V naught is having the voltage greater than or 0.3 or 0.20. Okay, that's all. But now what about the case that if beta is finite? Okay, and or we can say what about the case when, okay, just forget about the case of beta is finite. We are still now in case number one only. What if we want current ratio other than one? Okay, over here current transfer ratio is one because since I naught equals to I reference, note that we are talking about case number one. So what we will do, both transistors are matched, but in order to have current transfer ratio to be different, the transistor must be unmatched. Okay, so let's say we have to adjust the ratio as I naught equals to m times I reference, we can see. So what for this we will simply do this I naught by I reference, since it is depending on area. So we can say it is area of emitter base junction of Q2 and same as area of emitter base junction of Q1. So alternatively we can say if ratio area ratio m is an integer, one can think of Q2 as equivalent to m transistors each matched to Q1 and connected in parallel. This is, we can consider this like that. Let me read. If the area ratio m is an integer, if m is an integer, then one can think of Q2 as equivalent to m transistors, okay, each matched means this m transistors among themselves are matched, okay, to Q1, but themselves are also matched and all are matched with Q1 and connected in parallel. Clear? So this we are doing in our VLSI circuits also. VLSI cases, W by L, we are matching for series and parallel ones. So that's all. Now let's move towards case number 2. That is, beta is finite. Now obviously when beta is finite, IB, since IC equals to beta times IB, because our assumption is that both transistors are in active mode, and in active mode only, this equation IC equals beta times IB is valid. So since IC equals beta times IB, what we can say? IB is IC by beta. So IC by beta current will flow through the base of Q1 and Q2. So as per Kirchhoff's current law, over here we have twice IC by beta. Clear? So now let us establish the relation between the I reference and IC. So simple. And over here also we have assumed that Q1 and Q2 are matched. So over here we can say I0 and it is same as IC. I hope it is visible. Now let me write simple KVL. So I reference can be written as IC plus twice IC by beta over here. I reference this node, KVL at this node, KCL at this node. I reference the incoming current and outgoing currents are IC and twice IC by beta. So we have written this. Now let us make IC as subject. So making IC as subject, we get IC by I reference, or we can say I reference equals to IC 1 plus 2 by beta. So IC equals to I reference upon 1 upon 2 plus beta. Clear? So we can write like this. And also IC is nothing but I naught. So we can write like this. I naught equals to IC equals to I reference upon 1 upon 2 plus beta. Okay, so this is a very important relation in case of finite beta. Okay, so let me write it again. Right? I naught equals to I reference beta upon beta plus 2. And this is the only equation that we need to remember. And no need to remember, just apply KCL at node of Q1 and we will get the result. So this is the thing which is to be noted. Now note that when beta approaches to infinity in this equation only, so as beta tends to infinity, we get I naught equals to I reference, and which is the case number 1. So this equation is valid. Okay, so the key point to be considered in case number 2 is that we assume that these two transistors are matched, that is the area of emitter base junction of Q1 and Q2 are same. Clear? And just applying KCL, we get this. Okay, so this is the equation which is very much important. So that's all for this. Thank you.